As the Union began to crumble in 1860, old political ties were broken up. The Democratic Party divided its loyalty between North and South. In no other occupation but politics, is it expected that a man will sacrifice honors, prestige, and his chosen career for a single issue? Lawyers, businessmen, doctors, all face difficult personal decisions involving their integrity. But few, if any, face them in the glare of the spotlight as do those in public office. The political chaos that preceded the war between the states demanded that a man stand up and be counted. On the eve of the Civil War, December 20th, 1860, Andrew Johnson, the Democratic senator from Tennessee, rose in the Senate.
I am opposed to secession. Mr. President, no state has the right to secede without the consent of the other states which ratified the compact. If the states have the right to secede at will or pleasure for real or imaginary evils or oppressions, then this government is at an end. It is no stronger than a rope of sand. Is not levying war against the United States treason? Is not an attempt to take its property treason? Is not an attempt to expel its soldiers treason? Is not an attempt to resist the collection of revenue or to expel your mails or to drive your courts from her borders treason? It is treason, and nothing but treason.
When the United States Senate was called into special session on July 4, 1861, Andrew Johnson was there, the only senator from the seceding states who refused to secede with them. He had to judge for himself which path to choose, which step would most help or hinder the ideals to which he was committed.